Good morning, friends. My name is Naveen Kumar. I'm a faculty of Classic KSIS and Study Circle of Dharwad. Today, we are going to discuss CSAT previous paper of 2020. So, in the last class, we discussed 2019 paper. So, today we are going to discuss a 2020 paper of CSAT, right? It will be helpful for tomorrow's examination of revision, okay? Let me see the friends. We'll move for the first question now. In this CSAT paper, I yesterday told you in the last classes, three sections are the reasoning, quants and English, right friends? So, I am solving the reasoning part of in the CSAT. So, here is the question here. A simple mathematical operation in each number of the sequence 14, 18, 20, 24, 30, 32 results in the sequence in respect to prime numbers. Which one of the following is the next number in the sequence? First, we will write down the that number series here. Here it is 14, 18, 20, 24, 30, then 32. Okay. We'll check it here, friends. Now, they are told here, in a simple mathematical operation in each number of the sequence 14, 18, 20, 24, 30, 32 results in the sequence in respect to prime numbers, right? Then the prime numbers means 14, these are not the prime numbers, okay? Next, we have to find out the here, what is the next missing number or the what the next number? Let me check here. If 14 minus 1, that is 13, it's a prime number. Minus 1, right friends, is a 17. Next here, minus 1, that is 19. Okay. Then here comes minus 1, 23. Then minus 1, 29. Then comes minus 1, here it is a 31. The next prime number should be, right friends, it is a 37. Okay, so 37, I did minus here, okay, but here it is, they added, I am showing them, by doing the minus 1, we get to know the prime numbers here, then the next prime number is a 37. If we add that plus 1 again to this one, then it will become a 38 for has for this series. So, 18, 14, 18, 20, 24, 30, 32 and the next series will be a 38. Your option is third option, right friends? So, this is your right answer. Okay, we'll move for the next now. Okay, let me see this question here. Consider the following arrangement that has some missing letters. Okay, so yesterday this question came in 2019 paper. Okay, which I solved in the part 2, right? Again, the same question repeated here. This is an alphabetical test. Let me check here. A, B, A, B. Then is a gap of here it is. Then again B, then gap here. Then B, C, B. Again, one more fill up gap here. Then D, C, D, C, D, E, D. Then gap here. By finding this, you don't have the exact proper alphabets here. Okay, which one I have to take? By checking the options, we get to know that. But by checking the all the options, if you check one or two, exact one, you will get the proper answer here. So, how we have to judge the this type of questions in the examination? Let me check here, friends. There is a series here, means the group of series. We'll check it here. A, B, A, B. For example, I'll take a A. Right? We'll make as a one group here. First one. Right? See the proper alphabet group here. A, B, A, B, A. Then B is there. Right? We'll take C, B, C, B, C, B. Then group number 2. Right, friends? Then they are given here. C, D, C, D, C. Again, third group. Then fifth one is D, E, D, E, D. This is a fourth group. Sorry, I told fifth. It's a fourth group. Right? See, 5 letters, we have made a 4 groups here. And that should be in a serial order and alphabetical. See, A, B, A, B, A, B, C, B, C, B, then C, D, C, D, C, then D, E, D, E, D, right, in the alphabetical order. So, option we will see, what have written here? A, C, C, and E. We will check in the option here. Right. Option number C is a right answer, friends. Okay. Fine, we will move for the next question now. So, let me see the third question here. Two statements S1 and S2 are given below, followed by a question. In S1, there are not more than two figures on any page of 51-page book, right? Not more than two figures, they are telling means. The number of pages are 51, right? The figures not more than two, they are telling like that. So, in the statement number 2, means S2, there is an at least one figure in every page. At least one figure in every page means 51 pages, then it will be a 51 figures. Here it is, they are doing more than, sorry, not more than two figures. Right. Let me see the question, friends, here. Okay. The state S1 is correct or S2 is correct. Okay. We have to judge this one here. Or both right or both wrong. Okay. Question here. Are there more than 100 figures in that book? Right. They are asking more than 100 figures. Why? Because in the state one, in the S1, they ask that there are not more than two figures of any page, right, of 51 pages. Means it will become as a 102 figures. Right, friends? We don't know exactly. Right. In the here it is, there is at least one figure in every page, they are telling, like, means only 51 pages, then 51 figures. Let me see the options here. Okay. That is a first option here. Sorry, question is, which one of the following is correct is a respect to above statement in the question? Which one? S1 is correct or S2 is correct, or both are correct or both are wrong, like that. So, first option here, both S1 and S2 are sufficient to answer the question. But neither S1 alone nor S2 alone is sufficient to answer the question. No, we can't say that one. Okay. First option will not be followed. Second one, here it is. S1 alone is sufficient to answer the question. No, we can't say that. Okay. Why? Because not more than two figures, but they are given only 51 pages. Right. Then it will become a 51 pages means not more than two figures means it will become a more than 100 figures. Right, friends? So, in it is S1 and S2 together are not sufficient to answer the question, right, friends? So, option number C is the right answer. Why? Because S1 and S2, we can't judge properly what is an exact answer, right? So, answer is option number C. Okay, friends, we will move for the next question now. Here it is. The blood relation they have given here, right? So, the fourth question. A family of two generations consisting of 6 members, P, Q, R, S, T and U. I'll mark the persons here, right? Then, before for solving this problem, I'll tell you, friends, here it is, we have to find out the gender, male and female, and we have to first find out the first generation, then second generation, then the third generation. Then we'll get the answer easily. Let me see here. The family of two generations consisting of 6 members, P, Q, R, S, T and U, has 3 males, okay? So, 3 males, I putting as a plus means males, and 3 females, as a 3 females minus. There are 2 married couples and 2 unmarried siblings. They said 2 married couples, then 2 unmarried siblings. Okay, siblings in the sense of brother, brother or sister, sister or brother or sister, like that. So, siblings full stop. Now, the problem starts here. U is P's daughter. U is a P's daughter, right? U is P's daughter and Q is R's mother-in-law. Q is R's mother-in-law. R's mother-in-law. R's mother-in-law means she is a daughter-in-law. So, here it is a minus. So, this person is a plus, husband and a wife. Right, friends? R's mother-in-law, full stop. T is an unmarried male. T is an unmarried male and S is a male. Means, obviously, they have told 2 married couples, yes. They didn't say the S is unmarried. Only they said T is unmarried. Right, friends? So, S and R is a husband and a wife. So, S plus. Then, siblings, 2 unmarried siblings are there. They are told that already is there. U is there, right? And T is unmarried. That is T. For example, T, unmarried male. Okay. Though it's a son of P and Q. Right, friends? I'll write it down here. Siblings. Okay. Now we'll check the question here. Which one of the following is correct, right? By checking the options, we get to note which is the answer by seeing the diagram. R is U's husband. R is U's husband. We can't, sorry, that is object. Obviously, that's a wrong. Why? Because R is also female and U is also female. So, first option is a wrong option. Second one is R is S's wife. R is S's wife. So right option here. Okay. Right. So second option is the right option. In again, two options are there. Let me check this one also. S is unmarried. Okay. Yes. No. S is married. This is also wrong. None of this. No. So answer is only two. Option number two is the right answer, friends. Okay. You can draw a diagram in any kind of, right, friends. Okay. The first generation and these two, four peoples are the second generation. The first generation comes P and Q. Husband, wife, one pair. Then S and R, one more couple. That is a husband, wife, two pairs. Two married couples. Then two, here it is, siblings, unmarried siblings. They are told that two unmarrieds. That is T and U, friends. Okay. We'll move for the next question now. If in a particular year, 12th January is a Sunday, then which one of the following is correct? Right, friends? So, it is in a calendar-based problem. They asked 12th January is a Sunday, then which one of the following is correct? Means, they give the four options here. 15th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. In the leap year, 15th July is Sunday. They are telling that if it is, we have to calculate that one. If it is correct, then it is correct. Or it is wrong, wrong means, okay? Then one more 15 given is in the normal year, not a leap year, right, friends? So I'll mark it here. So that is a, this one is normal, okay? In the option C, again they are given 12th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. Then 12th July is not a Sunday if the year is a leap year, right? Let me check here this one. So this is also, we'll check the options here. One second, friend. 12th July is not a Sunday if the year is a leap year. Okay, so these four options are there. We have to calculate this 15-15, and there is a difference of here it is, in the leap year 2 odd days, in the normal year 1 odd day, right, friends? In February 28, in the leap year February 29, that's it. In the same also July 12th and July 12th here. Let me check in the option number 1. First they have given 12th January is a Sunday, right, friends? Before starting that one, I'll tell you, we have to take here which day they have mentioned there, that day is called as a zero, as a Sunday. Sunday means they have given Sunday, so I am taking zero as a Sunday. If they are given any Monday, Tuesday or Thursday, whatever it may be, I am going to take zero as the that day. So zero is a Sunday, one means Monday, two is a Tuesday, so Wednesday, Thursday, then Friday, it's 7 days, right, friends? So here it is, 15th July is a Sunday. First option, they're telling that 15th July is a Sunday, right? It's a, for the option they're telling that 15th July is Sunday if the year is a leap year. If the year is a leap year means we have to calculate it. 15 means 31st minus 15, that is on a 19 year, plus leap year 29 31 plus 30 31, okay, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, 15th, that's it. When we added this all, it will be a 185, right, friends? So 185 means number of days, that is 7, then we have to calculate it, okay? The C here it is 6, the remainder is a 3. So remainder is 3 means check the options here, right? So 3 is a Wednesday. Okay, they're telling that 15 July is a Sunday. No, that is a wrong one, right? Same here in the normal year, in 15 July, it will be a 184 divided by 7. Same the calculation part is, right? Again here, remainder is 2, right, friends? The 2 is a Tuesday. Okay, so second 15th option is also wrong option, right? We'll check in the 2 12th options. That is option number C, 12th July is a Sunday if year is a leap year. So that is a 12th July, that is 19 plus again 29, same as it is, 31 plus 30 plus 31, okay, February, March, April, May, June, July 12th, that's it. We have taken July 15, the both options, here it is 112. When we added this one, it will be a 182, then divided by 7. Here it is 2, then remainder, here it is 42, that is 6. Remainder is a 0. Okay, 0 is a Sunday, right? So let me check the option. Yes, 12th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. Yes, friends, the option number C is the right answer. Right, friends? Okay, we'll move for the next question now. Question number 6, two statements S1 and S2 are given below with regard of four numbers P, Q, R and S followed by questions, right? In S1, R is greater than P as well as Q. I write it down here, R is greater than P as well as Q, right? Second, in S2, S is not the largest, means S is not the largest means S is greater than P, it might be, S is greater than Q, it might be, or S is less than Q, P and R also, right? So question is, among the four members P, Q, R and S, which one of the largest? We know that, get to know that the largest is R here, right? R is not the largest, they already said here. So R is the largest person. Question, which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statement and the question? Here it is, S1 alone is sufficient to answer, no. S2 alone is sufficient to answer the question, no. Option number C, S1 and S2 together are sufficient to answer the question, but neither S1 alone nor S2 alone is sufficient to answer the question, right? So option number C is a right answer, friends. Okay, fine, we'll move for the next question now. Okay, so direction test problem is this one. A man walked down the back side of his house straight 25 meters, then turned to the right and walks 50 meters again. Then he turns towards the left and again walks 25 meters. If his house faces to the east, what is his direction from the starting point? Okay, let me draw the diagram here, friends. Here it is. The basic thing is I'll write down here, north, south, east, west, the directions. Okay, for example, the house facing to the east, here it is, 25 meters, then turns to the right and walks 50 meters, again turns to the left and walks 25 meters. The question is, if his house faced to the east, yes, his house to face to the east, what his direction from the starting point? Friends, this is the starting point here. Okay, from here to here, starting point to which direction? Just we have to put one plus here, right? Right. So here it is north, south, east, west. In between of it is northeast. Here it is southeast, southwest. This one is a northwest. So option number D is the right answer. Okay, friends. Yes. We'll move for the next question now. Okay. The two statements are given followed by two conclusions. The statement one is here. All numbers are divisible by 2, and statement number 2, all numbers are divisible by 3. Okay, divisible by 2 and divisible by 3. The conclusion number 1, all numbers are divisible by 6, then all, conclusion number 2, all numbers are divisible by 4, right? So as per the statement, the conclusion only 1 is the true. Why? Because the 6 is, all numbers is divisible by 2 and 3. Okay, 6 is okay. Then conclusion number 2, all numbers are divisible by 4, that is wrong. We can't do that one. Okay, it will not be divisible by 4, these two numbers, by as per the statement. So conclusion 1 is a right answer, friends. Okay, fine, we'll move for the next question now. Okay, the two statements are given followed by two conclusions. All cats are dogs. It's a syllogisms. We also called as Venn diagrams. I draw the diagram here. In the statements, only we are drawing the diagram to the statements, not for the conclusions. Let me check the statement here. All cats are dogs. Here it is. All cats are dogs. Then all cats are black. All cats are black. Right? So this is, they have given all. Okay, one more option also come, that is called possibility. Okay, like this, cat, here it is dog, then black, like this. Okay. Conclusion number one, all dogs are black. All dogs are black. Wrong. All dogs are black. No, we can't say both the section. Conclusion number two, some dogs are not black. Some dogs are not black. No, some dogs are black here. Here also some dogs are black. So both options wrong. Okay. The option is neither. Neither conclusion one and two conclusion is follows. Option number C. Okay, friends, we'll move for the next one now. Consider the following the sequence of numbers 5147398573153863852234346. They're given the particular given one arrangement of numbers here. In this one, they're asking how many odd numbers are followed by odd number in the above sequence, right? Here it is. Mention the question here, means particularly we have to mark the question what they asked. Here it is. How many odd numbers are followed by the odd number, right? So let me check here, odd one here. Followed means I told you in the classes also, okay? Followed in front of us, okay? Preceded by the behind, right? So odd, 5 and 1, it's a one pair. Again, odd and followed by odd number. Two pairs, again 3 and 9, okay? Odd number, 9, odd number is followed by 3. Three pairs, four pairs here, 5 and 7. Then six pairs, 1 and 5, right? 5 and 6 pairs. Any other pairs are there? Odd, here it is, 3, 8, no, 5, 2, no, even is there, right? 3, 4, no, 9, 6, no. So only six pairs are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So option number B is a right answer, friends. Okay, for the next question now. Okay, question number 11. A is 16th from the left end in the row of boys and V is 18th from the right end of right end. Full stop. G is 11th from A towards the right end of right end and third from V towards the right end. How many boys are there in the class? So, friends, let me check here. This is A 16th place, right? Then V 18th place, right? So G is a 11th place right side from the A. 11th place right side from the A means, okay, here it is 1, 2, 3. Here it is G, 11th place, okay? Here it is 3% means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry, we'll cancel one. There is one more V here. Okay. Right. Now, G is 11th from right side of A and third from right side of V. Right. Let me check how many boys are there in the class. The question is. So, here it is. The V's position is 18th from the right side. 18th from the right side. And what is his position from the left side means? 16 plus 11 minus 3, that is 24th place, right, friends? It's a 24th. Hence the total number of boys in the row, okay, again 18 plus 24, okay, here it is 42, right, friends? But the V we counted as two times. One is 18th place is V from right side. When we count from the left side, is the 24th place. Again, we have 24. That is, we have to take only one time. That is a minus 1. Means a 41 answer. Right, friends? So, option is B. Option number B is a right answer, friends. Yes, we'll move for the next question now. Here, next question, friends. Three statements, S1, S2 and S3 are given below, followed by a question. S1, C is younger than D. C is younger than D. But older than A and B. Okay. C is the oldest. D is the second. S2 is, D is the oldest. Then S3. A is older than B. Yes, A is older than B. Now see the question here. Who among A, B, C, D is the youngest? Right? So here it is. We'll check the options here. S1 alone is sufficient to answer the question. No. Then S1 and S2 together are sufficient to answer the question. Option number 3, S2 and S3 together are sufficient to answer the question. No, we can't say. Option number 4, S1 and S3 together to sufficient to answer the question. Yes. So option number D is the right answer. Why? Because we are judging here S1 and S3. We are getting the exact value of the particular persons, right? So D is the oldest. We got it, that one, that A is older than B. Here we get to know that A is older than B. Here we can't judge at all, right? So C is younger than D. C is younger than D, but older than A and B. Here it is. So option number D is a right answer, friends. Okay, we'll move for the next question. The letters from A to Z are numbered from 1 to 26 respectively. If G H I is equal to 587 and D E F is equal to 912, then A B C question mark. First we get to know, we have to find the A B C, what is the code. Before that, we'll find out how the GHI got 1578 here. Here it is. We'll write down the code here, respectively from 1 to 26 alphabetical order. G code is 7, H code is 8, 9, right? So what they did, 15 means they did into 2, right friends? That is 1578. Same as it is, 4, 5, 6 into 2, 912. Here it is 1, 2, 3 into 2, right friends? Here it is. Okay, 246, then option number D, right friends? Okay, we'll move for the next question now. What is the missing term at in the following? Missing term, see, they have given here A, C, P, Q, then B, E, S, U. Then how about M, N, G, I? Here the question mark, right friends? So first we have to find out here A, B, it become plus 1, C, E, plus 2, then P, S, plus 3, Q, U, plus 4, right? In the same way, M, N, G, I, M plus 1, N, O, P, plus 2, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. Then N, P, J, M, option number D. Here it is, the concept is plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 and plus 4 concept, right? Okay friends, we'll move for the next question now. How many different 5 letter word with or without meaning can be constructed using all the letters of the word Delhi? So that each word has to start with a D and end with I. So D and I is a fixed letters. Okay, the remaining 3 will be changed by changing of the place. How many times means it is a 3 into 6, that is answer is 6. Right friends? Why? Because by changing the letters here one by one, okay, all the letters will get the 2-2 pairs, that is a 6. So directly we take a 3 into 2, that is 6. Answer is option number D. So we'll take the next question. Consider the following the statement. The minimum number of points of intersection of the square and a circle is 2. Right friends? So here they are saying that I'll read it once. The minimum number of points of intersection of the square and a circle is 2, okay. In the second point, the maximum number of the points of the intersection of the square and a circle is 8. Which one of the above statement is are correct? Right friends? We'll solve in the next page this one. The first point. Right. So here it is 1 and 2. Right friends? Let me check here. The minimum number of points of intersection of square and circle is 2. Okay. That is right, 2 here, A and B, 2 points. Right. In the second question, what they said? the maximum numbers of points of intersection of the square and circle is 8. Okay, fine. Let me check in the next circle, second sequence. Right, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, 8 here, intersection, right friends? Okay, here it is, see. The maximum number of the points, intersections of the square and the circle is 8, that is also true. So answer both 1 and 2 is right. 1 and 2, here it is 2 and here it is a 8. Right, friends? Okay. Yes. Anyhow, thank you, friends. So, it will be helpful for your examination, right? So, be prepared and for tomorrow's examination, okay, for the, all the best for your examination and do well and don't make hurry-burry while solving the paper, right? That should be in the calculation part. And second thing is, don't commit mistakes in your OMR sheets, okay? Take a few minutes more. Okay, but you mark the answer, right answer. Why? Because I'm telling, because it's a OMR sheet, you are marking there. If you committed any mistake, no, it will be a problem to you, right? Anyhow, good luck. Thank you very much.